So let's get to this, because again, at this Elseworld approach, there is a since he's not doing the Snyderverse, right? I think Gunn made this very clear. He's not doing the Snyderverse, and so this new initiative, that's come up, and people that some of my mutuals and people that's been on the channel, they came up with this idea of let's petition Netflix. And see, we're gonna get into it now, y'all. I'm telling you, we're getting into it now. So they must petition Netflix to, push for, to license out certain versions of DC characters, right?
Right.
Just when I put it the simplest way possible, that's what this come down to, right? Like, can you license out, character A, B, C, D, and etc. There's different examples, like people use with Sandman and things like that. And we definitely gonna get your full take on this as well with this, because I see a lot of people, they're making this conversation. This is my problem, Brian. Well, this is my stance, and I'll kind of make this official here. The idea of licensing, I totally rock with that idea. And I said, yo, it doesn't hurt to put that idea out there. Right. I think ultimately, we'll get into like the costs that will be involved, the time, the having people available to do it. There's a lot of factors into this. Mm-hmm. And I totally see all of that. Just the idea of having them license out characters, I'm like, hey, that is worth a shot. And we could talk about what form that would take, because a lot of people have they're making this more like it has to be this way for it to work. When I'm saying, let's have Netflix raise that conversation. And at the end of the day, if we get a Snyderverse, a limited series, I will be cool with that. I'll be like, okay, it's not the three movies, the five movies that we wanted, but I got a little series that's in that world. I'll be like, yo, we did our best, and it's like that. So when we go forward in this conversation, I'm always going to come back to that simple way of saying it's just about licensing characters. Now, cost, everything, like, we'll touch all that. So, Prime, when you've just first heard this idea of petitioning Netflix to, to do the Snyderverse, right? We just say it's like, there's a hashtag sell ZSJO to Netflix, hashtag sell Snyderverse to Netflix. Right. Your initial, now, maybe not the way that you expressed it when you initially heard it, but what was your initial just response to that?
Well, my initial response was that it has merit. Mm-hmm. It has merit. I see what everybody was trying to do. It has merit, but it's crazy.
Okay, we keep it real here. So yeah,
you have to really have to look at it and be real with it, because mm-hmm. it's not like, when I saw it, I was like I say, it has merit. Zach is at mm-hmm. Netflix. If he has time to do it, mm-hmm. and Netflix mm-hmm. decides that, let's do business.
Right.
It's not up to Netflix. It's up to Warner Brothers.
Well, they have to agree, to.
Right. Warner Brothers will have to agree. And so that would be the only thing. Now, when you're looking mm-hmm. at it on the back end, on the business end, Warner Brothers would never agree to it.
Now, before you go there, because I know where you're going, and we're going to flesh this all out. But just let's say, just perfect circumstance. I know we don't live in a perfect world, and we won't have these circumstances. But right. let's just say Netflix is willing to pay any price to do it. All the actors will be available to do it. And Warner's wants to make money off of it. Where is the crazy part with that? That's why we're like, just the idea.
The crazy part would be is that how will Netflix reassure that Warner Brothers is going to get a profit for you licensing it out?
Okay. So let's go. Because going back to the business. Yes, right. Let's
because
go with that.
Because it's not theatrical.
Okay.
It's streaming. Right.
It can't be theatrical. See, so now it's like, because again, I tried to start with the DreamWorld approach where,
right.
let's say everything falls in line. This is not a bad idea. Now let's, this may be uncomfortable for some people. Let's talk about why it probably can't happen. Now, I still have reasons why I still think there's a way for this to work. But let's get into that. You raise a really, really, I think people are missing. It can't be theatrical. There is no way Warner's would license out the Trinity, basically.
Yeah.
Justice League overall.
For streaming.
You know, their top, you know, 7 of their top 10 characters, right, in comics. They wouldn't do that for what I'm saying. They won't do it for theatrical. They wouldn't say, okay, Universal.
Even if Justice it's theatrical, League. They wouldn't do it.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, just a theatrical point. If they're like, you know, Universal wants to do it, let's license it out so Universal can put a film out in theaters, the Justice League? That would never happen.
That would never happen. To the right? People, y'all got to fail to understand. And a good thing you got me on here, because I said on my my video, and I'll tell people this. You have tiers. So when you have tiers of characters, all right, it's like your so people can understand what I mean. It's like your stars on your team, right? Mm-hmm. You got your big hitter. You got your main stars on contract. You ain't trading them. That's your franchise. Mm-hmm. You're not getting rid of them. Right. You're going to do whatever it is in your power to make sure they stay put. Now, in certain cases, it doesn't happen because they become free agents. But that'll be the only way. But in this case, when it comes down to licenses that you own for life, they're not giving that up. They're not going to let nobody sniff it.
So now we know, you know, again, because I wanted to attack that early with the theatrical part, because people, I still see people trying to say, well, let's ask for this instead. It's like, take that theatrical part out of your mind. That's not happening. So let's, you know, so with streaming, you raised a great point saying, if it's streaming, and usually a license deal is, you know, whatever you get from this engagement, advertising dollars, whatever Netflix gets, like from Sandman, Warner's has to get a cut of that. Or Netflix could say, we can go into our reserve and pay for the license up front, which they won't do. Okay, they won't do that. Mm-hmm. But what I'm saying is that if they pay up front, which never happens, then, you know, then it's Netflix profit. What Netflix does, and why Zaslav got upset with Netflix, if people remember a few months ago, Sandman was a hit last year, right?
Exactly.
And Netflix didn't have to pay them for, according to their agreement, within 18 months.
Yep.
Meaning Netflix got all that engagement. Netflix got an advertising tier on Netflix too. So they got more advertising dollars, more subs and everything with that, right? And they didn't have to pay that bill, right? To simplify it for people, for 18 months? Meaning they probably ain't even pay for Sandman. Yeah, I don't know if it starts with the production or when it comes out, right? So you see what I'm saying? So people understand why Zaslav got upset, right? He's like, hey, wait a minute.
That's what I'm saying.
Y'all trying to do season two. You know what I'm saying? You trying to do season two and I ain't get paid yet for season one?
Yes.
Yeah, I ain't doing season two yet. That's what Zaslav, you know. Now, I think they worked it out. Yep. So this is the thing here. And I want you to get your thought on this. That if, with that scenario, let's say they do the Snyderverse next year, you know, on Netflix. Whatever price they agree to. Is there a scenario where Warner's wouldn't, Netflix probably wouldn't make enough, you feel, and I'll let you speak for yourself with that, but it was like, is it possible, for them to even make enough to make it worthwhile?
No, because let's just say, all right, Netflix were willing to get the license, they say, well, we got the money for the license, okay, but there's other elements to with these characters. We just gonna go with one, okay? Yeah. We gonna go with Big Blue, just to use them. Not happening. Warner Brothers might not know. We want you to give us $5 billion just to license it. We want you to give us another billion for the marketing. For the licensing, for the marketing, for the merchandising, all that stuff. Now, you got to mind you, if they're giving up that money, the shareholders for Netflix is like, well, where are we going to get this extra money at to get this profit? If you don't get the subscriptions. Now, mind you, Netflix has been losing subscribers, and then their subscriber signups, that stuff fluctuate, people. Netflix just don't get money just out the blue. Like you get theatrical. You see what I'm saying? It don't happen like that. The more money they put out, All right. The more they lose. The more they lose. So people thinking, well, they got to get the signups. Okay, let's say hypothetically, like, all this people start to realize Netflix is not in the black. They're not. But they have enough stuff. They have enough stuff to keep it going, to have money come in because of those subscriptions to keep it afloat. That will never happen. People think it because of net worth, and they
That's a fair point. That's a fair point. So like
the net worth is what they know. No.
A lot of people point to last year. I just want to interject on one point you just said. Last year Netflix did have their first drop ever in subs, right? And people panic because they're like, we're coming out of a pandemic.
Yes.
And you know what I'm saying, it dropped. And that caused Netflix stocks to drop. And so Netflix is king of streaming. So, but what that meant was, if Netflix dropped, then Disney Plus stocks dropped.
You know, Disney's dropped now, and they get
HBO Max dropped. Now Disney has their own issues that you see Iger has to scramble for that. But when Netflix got hit, it hurt the whole streaming game. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But I will say, since then though, Netflix, they have reported gains going into this new year, and they are still gaining. But I see your point as far as with they had their worst year last year, right? They did rebound, but they had to cut a lot of content. It was more quality over quantity, right? It was a time, if you wanted to make any kind of film, just, you know what I'm saying, Netflix would cut you a deal. They just wanted as much content as possible.
Yep.
Didn't matter if it was good or bad, right? And then they got that hit with a Squid Game, where the whole world watched it. Mm-hmm. They got these K-dramas, and they're like, okay, why we got all this fluff and we're losing subs? After you had Squid Game and you lost subs, something ain't right. Right? And so I just wanted to interject with that, because when you mentioned their money struggles, that was the crux of it. Now they have recovered, but I do see why people are like, well, they're still kind of shaky. I think that was the point you was kind of making.
Because this is the thing that people need to understand. You still have to appease shareholders. Where are you going to get this money? If I'm going to invest, and you think, again, where are we going to get this money? That's easy for Warner Brothers to do. See, Warner Brothers is not in bankruptcy. People fail to realize that. They're not in bankruptcy.
No, they're just in debt.
They're just in debt.
You know, they've been carrying that debt for decades, right? They've been carrying
debt. What I mean? It's a big difference. Yeah. If they was in bankruptcy, you're saying a different story. They're just in major debt.
Yeah, so Zaslav is just like, we could pay this down now. Yep. The former regime, you know, just chose not to. Like, I will float it. That's like, like, I had this old studio apartment when I was in college. And, like, I couldn't pay the rent, you know what I'm saying, that first month. So I was like, let's try to float it to next month, right? And that's what Warner's been kicking the can down the road for years.
Yes.
That's why they were so willing to sell to AT&T. The AT&T said, man, we can't fix this. You know, we're not media. So Zaza swoops in, and Zaza's like, I know how to cut this down. Let's cut out a lot of these movies. It's Wonder Twins and stuff you're doing. Batgirl, shelve it, tax write-off. So he's trying to aggressively pay it down. But you raise a good point right there that Warner's is only in debt. They're not in bankruptcy.
Right. And the people for to realize this too, and think about this. Let's just say hypothetically, it's going to get to the point. Mm-hmm. If The Flash makes over $1 billion, they're going to make a major profit.
Oh, yeah. Ooh.
They're going to make a major profit. Yeah. So what that does, that go in their book, that means it's going to put them ahead. Mm-hmm. Because they're going to make a profit. We know that everything else is going to make a profit. Well, let's say hypothetically they don't. They still ahead. Right. So that's what I'm saying. So we're going to, anything that comes out now, they're banking on one of the movies to at least be successful and get a big jump. Flash is making $1 billion.
I think they put their chips in The Flash.
Yeah, Flash making $1 billion. It is.
Because wouldn't that make them look, you talking about the brand of Warner, wouldn't it make them look good? You got a summer blockbuster, right? You had the Super Bowl commercial. Mm-hmm. Again, it's all about, like you said, the shareholders and the advertising dollars, the people that want sponsors and things like that. You have a summer blockbuster, I guarantee when the summer comes along, you're going to have like a Flash pizza. You're going to have all kinds of
that
stuff.
That marketing and that merchandise.
You know what I'm saying?
Over the hump too.
Yeah.
So people, you got to you got to look at all that stuff, man. You have to look at all that stuff. And now let's go ahead and go this thing and what I said too. The first and second tier characters, they ain't licensing them out. They won't even let nobody touch them. Now, when you get to the third and fourth and fifth tier, oh, they might license them out all day. They're like, oh, we'll give you this. What you plan on doing with it? Want to know why? Because Warner Brothers gonna get a cut.
Explain this part, because that was a. I remember. I think you was in a chat talking about this, and I was like, that's a good point Prime has, right? And with me, because I have an open mind with this entire situation, I see an avenue, and we'll kind of get to that conclusion eventually. I see how this actually could work with getting a version, and I say this on purpose, a version of the Snyderverse license. I do see a way for this to work, but let's just do just a bare bones about it, right? Licensing out live action Trinity. That's a hard sell. That's a hard sell. But now, when you say, you know, other tiers, just explain why are you coming to that conclusion? I have an idea why you are, just for the sake of the conversation.
Okay, so this is what I mean by first and second tiers. I said in my video, my breakdown of what I stated, but I'll say it here. First tier and second tier characters are this: Big Blue, Batman, Wonder Woman, Aquaman, Green Lantern, Martian Manhunter. You got Flash. You got the big guns. DC.
Oh, Joker, Harley.
Let's go to villains. Lex Luthor, Joker. You got Zod. You got Lex. I said Lex Luthor. You got
those like the top of the top right there. And then it's
the list goes on with DC with top characters. They ain't letting nobody touch that.
So where do you think it starts? Now we're talking about live action, right? That's what because we'll get to other. I always have a wiggle room somewhere, but just with straight up live action, we're saying just straight up a film. I don't see them licensing out for a full length feature film of a Superman, a Batman, Justice League. All that's all A tier to me. I think the entire Justice League is A tier. You mentioned Joker, Harley. That's all A tier.
Teen Titans, Justice League, and the Trinity.
When you get to like B side, that's why I'm thinking more of like the Nightwing, and people like that in the B. Though he could be A in some way.
No, that would be second tier.
Second tier.
That's second tier. Nightwing will be second tier. When you get down to the third tier, if you're going to go with the Bat family, that'll be like Batwoman.
Batwing.
Batwoman, or you might get Batwing, or what I'm saying? I would put, now, Batgirl is
Batgirl is second tier.
Tier with Batgirl. That's what I'm saying. You got to be certain characters.
Like, I'm saying Batwing and them are like under second. I'm saying that's like D-listers. Batgirl is second tier. Yeah.
Right. So when you get to that's what I'm saying.
Okay.
These are people that are like third and fourth tier. Sandman is third tier. Yeah. Even though Sandman is in continuity of DC and he's in there a lot, but he's third tier.
See, this is probably the best point, because I remember when you brought that up, the tiers, and I was like, Prime has a point right there that, and then we're talking about live action people. Wood Warner's, you got Gunn writing a Superman film of his life right now, right? Mm-hmm. And you'll license out another Superman?
Not to compete. That
live action. I'm just like, let's think about what we're asking for here, right? And so now some say Prime, they'll say, well, that's that whole competition argument.
There you go.
Okay, so, and this, I'm just... when I ask this question, don't look at me like, oh, you dumb, Seal. I'm just for the sake of the conversation. So some people will say, well, what about the J.J. Abrams, Ta-Nehisi Coates, Black Superman? They still may make that, right? Like, how can they do that in-house, Prime, but don't want to do that separately?
That's very easy to answer so people can understand. All right? Superman is Earth One. Calvin Ellis and Val Zod is Earth 2, Earth 4. That's a multiverse.
And that's not top tier.
That's a totally different universe.
That's that third tier argument.
That third tier, fourth tier. Yeah. That's a totally different universe. Ain't got nothing to do with anything.
So that's another
go ahead. Like for example, even though they might not let them use it, but I give y'all examples of the third and fourth tier. Milestone characters, Wildstorm characters.
Yeah,
you got certain characters that's in the Black Label that you don't know. For example, Swamp Thing. I don't even know what I'll put Swamp Thing. I think I put Swamp Thing a second tier.
That's getting a second. Well, after that series, that's borderline.
That's
there,
but that's the thing. So when you get to stuff like that, you have to look at it. If they want to do the Black Superman, Calvin Ellis said what they want to do and want to build a universe off of that, you can license that out anywhere. That's easy. That's easy. Like, but, you know what I'm saying? That's easy. If they want to do, let's just say, which is a gold, well, I'm going to tell you this, they probably won't license it out because they know it's a gold mine. Let's just say, hypothetically, they said, you know what? We're going to license out the whole Milestone catalog to someone and they can utilize it. They could do that. They own the license to the characters. It won't be a lot to license them out, okay?
Right.
Once their popularity gets up, it'll
be a
different
story.
Still
own the rights, so
right,
yeah.
Right. But Warner Brothers ain't dumb because they know Milestone is a gold mine. If they
Gunn's
do.
Using Milestone, I think he actually said
because
that too.
The people
he?
Don't know what Milestone is. That's Static Shock. That's Icon and Rocket. That's hardware.
Yep. Hardware. Man. That's the boy right
they
there.
Know. They
Blood
know
Syndicate.
That's a gold mine. They know that is, but they could use those for something else. DC has so much stuff. So you can't say that you can't outsource these other characters, like Mr. Terrific. He's not a first and second tier character. He's like third and fourth.
Yeah.
But he's one. He's a very, very DC mythos for the people that are DC people know who he is. Black Lightning, they know who he is.
Yeah.
He's part of the Justice League, but he's a third, fourth tier character.
Yeah.
You know, Green Arrow.
That's probably second tier only because the show blew it up.
You getting in there. Yeah. But, you know, you got Firestorm. You got Power Girl. You can license them out.
Yeah. You know like these alternate takes.
Right. Or, you know what? And this is a question for me. Even if you did the Thanagarians, you could do a Thanagarians thing if you wanted to. Hawk Girl and Hawk Girl with their universe.
So this is an interesting question because we just had, live action, Black Adam.
Right.
And he had the JSA. You know, Black Adam, just according to the returns, he's third tier. Right?
Third tier.
You know what I mean? And so I put JSA kind of under that as well, too, just off of the popularity that,
There you go.
I could see, I don't think this is going to happen, but I could see where, Gunn's like, well, we're not going to use Black Adam or I may use Black Adam for a future Shazam or something like that, but. I could see them license that out for, again, a live action depiction, right? Mm-hmm. So let me get to my point, because why I keep stressing live action. The feature length film, I don't see that happening. To license out something to Netflix, one way I think it could happen is if it's like a series type of format. Yep. I think that's just like, and again, there's a lot of logistics to that as well, too, that, we can go through a lot. But I don't see, and this is, I'm someone that actually is saying, hey, Netflix should have that conversation with DC, with Warners. I don't see Warner saying, okay, you can do a feature length film with A-list characters. I don't see that happening at all. A series, something like a limited series, like a one-shot, a story in that world, something in that, just in that nature, right? I mean, it's going to take a lot of moving parts still. Do you see, just as a possibility, a series type of approach? Now, we could talk about the problems they could face with that, but just, is that more palatable than saying, like, do JL 2 and 3? Because I'm just, the more you look at it, I was like, oh, yeah, I don't see them really.
No.
Saying go and do a Justice League film, what I'm saying?
You can't, even with those, you can't do a series and you can't do a live action. It won't happen.
What about, like, and what I mean by series,
I'm talking Zack about, you talking about the, you're talking about the first tier characters?
Yeah, well, yeah, we're still talking about first tier. Yeah, yeah.
First tier,
yeah.
It won't happen. Yeah. No, they won't do that.
So
no.
When I say series, like a in a setting, okay, so let me just say what I'm trying to get to. So I think the only way we'll get like a live action Snyderverse type of project on a Netflix or whatever, or something outside of it, is that it would literally have to be in like a nightmare world, because that's in a sense out of continuity. You see what I'm saying? Like, and again, we can get into like, you know, how that couldn't work, why that wouldn't work, because you may have to think about recasting some people. You may have to, just this concept of it's in this war-torn world. We're not going to like Metropolis, right? We're not going to, you know, regular Gotham, right? Just as an idea, what do you think? What do you think with that?
Well, it won't happen because it will never happen, because you still have to outsource the license for the characters.
You still have to have Batman, a version of Batman.
Just put it like this, just from the Trinity alone. Just for the Trinity alone. All right. And I'm just throwing numbers out there. I'm just throwing numbers out there. Like I said before, just to even get Superman and knowing that's the big hunter. Okay. Mm-hmm. One of us can say, you know, just to get the license, we're going to charge you $5 billion. So let's just say they're going to charge $5 billion per each character.
I mean, I think it's absorbent. I think, yeah, we're talking about billions.
Right.
I don't think just $5 billion is the number, but yeah, I see what you're saying.
$15 billion to license.
Just for the sake of the example.
Right. That's just the example. We ain't even getting to production yet. We ain't even getting to marketing. We ain't even getting to, you know, the marketing. And the merchandising, we ain't even getting that yet. So
yeah, that's gonna be all Warner's cut. Like any merchandise they even try to put out, Warner's like Netflix ain't getting none of that.
Right, you know what I'm saying? None of that. So that's what I'm saying. Netflix on their end will be taking a major L because they're not gonna get a profit.
So because it would be a huge price, just again, for Bruce Wayne Batman, you know. Diana Prince and Wonder Woman, right? You know what I'm saying? Kal-El, Clark Kent, Superman. Like that name is going to hold a lot of value for Warners, right? And, and Netflix paying for that and to, you know, to actually get some kind of profit, that would be an issue. Now, some people aren't going to like this idea, but to do Snyder's story and use like an alternate Batman. I'm just spitballing right now, but like, just, you know, do a nightmare of project, but Batman is Thomas Wayne. I'm just throwing something out there, right? Something like that. You know, have a Yara Flora to be the Wonder Woman. you see what I'm saying? Do John Kent. Now, I'm pretty sure Gunn's not going to let John Kent go, but I'm just saying, like, use John Kent, you know, as the Superman. Now, Snyder fans, and you know, including, I mean, we're both Snyder fans, we wouldn't want that version of that story. You know what I'm saying? You see what I'm saying? Like Batman is a Jace Fox. No one wants to see no Jace Fox acting like he Bruce Wayne. So we're running into it's the live action argument that I think, you know, we're taking different routes, but we're kind of coming to the same conclusion that the price tag. Now, again, I think it's up to Netflix to determine, you know, how much they're willing to pay. But that great fact check with any of these business companies is the shareholders. What are they going to think if you spend? And I think $15 billion is too big of a, like, I don't think it's going to be that much. But I think it'll be in the billions.
I would say for Superman by itself, I believe it will be $5 billion just to get them. Just to use them.
That would be insane, just right? Let's just say, just for the sake of just my argument here, let's just say for all three is $5 billion altogether. I still think they shouldn't pay that much, right?
But that's what you I'm see saying. What I'm saying?
But that would be, and we'll kind of get to some the controversial comments that's out there, the tweets that we're going to bring up in a moment. I still think that's a conversation, you know, that's up to Netflix to have that conversation. And I still think there is an end game in this where maybe a form of this story still can happen. But I just want to stamp home the live action conversation. I don't think Netflix would be willing to pay that cost as a business, as stockholders looking at the choices. I think they would fire the CEO of Netflix if he signed off on a $5 billion deal for a live action Justice League, right? Like, I mean,